Dr. Vimalathirthan Rathinasabapathi, Professor and Head of the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering in Aditya Institute of Technology, Coimbatore. Doctorate in the field of crypt analysis in Government College of Technology, Coimbatore. Postdoctoral Fellow in the Department of Information Engineering, University of Padova, Italy. He is very much interested in research area of cryptography, crypt analysis, electromagnetic interference, compatibility, antenna design, wireless sensor network and communication. He has published papers in international journals and international national conferences. He is a reviewer of journals like DRDO, WSCAS, International Journal of Network Security, and also have a membership in professional bodies like CRSI, IACR and Computer Society of India.
Welcome to UGC lecture series, Communication Electronics for Applied Electronics. In the today's session, we are going to see about the detection of frequency modulated wave. The types of frequency modulated detector are slope detector, balanced slope detector, faster Seeley discriminator and ratio detector. What is frequency demodulation? The process of recovering the audio signal from the modulated wave is known as demodulation or detection. Frequency demodulation is a process in which the original message signal is recovered from the incoming frequency modulated wave. In other words, simply the frequency demodulation is the inverse of frequency modulation. A frequency discriminator, that is demodulator, depends on slope detection followed by envelope detection. There are two stages for FM demodulation. The first stage is converting the frequency modulated signal into amplitude variation using frequency dependent circuit. That is, in case of frequency modulation, the message signal amplitude is used to vary the carrier frequency. That is, the carrier frequency is shifted within that FC plus del F and FC minus del F in accordance with the message signal. The reverse process, this frequency deviation has to be reconverted into the amplitude variation. So, this is done first using the frequency discriminator. The second stage is feeding this AM signal into a linear diode detector to extract the original modulating signal. As we already seen, the types of demodulation, there are four types, that is slope detector, balanced slope detector, faster Seeley discriminator and ratio detector. First, we will see the slope detector. This is a simple circuit that shows the slope detector. It consists of a tank circuit or tuning circuit. Here, the incoming frequency modulated wave is fed to a transformer, and here the secondary of the transformer along with this variable capacitor act as a tuning circuit. Here, we will see how the variation in frequency is converted into amplitude. So, thereafter we can go for a simple diode detector to detect the original signal. This is the characteristics of the slope detector. Here in x axis we have frequency and in y axis we have the output voltage. So, this is the incoming frequency and this is the output voltage. Here at this point we have the carrier frequency, that is the frequency at which the FM signal is transmitted. In case of modulation, FC, FC plus del F, FC minus del F. When the message signal is 0, then the signal will be transmitted with carrier frequency. During the positive peak of the message signal, the carrier is shifted to FC plus del F, and during the negative peak, the carrier is shifted to FC minus del F. So, between the positive peak and negative peak, the carrier will be shifted within this range. So, we have to reconvert this process to detect the amplitude variation. Here, When the incoming signal is of frequency fc, then what should be the amplitude? It should be 0. If we consider here, the amplitude of the signal is 0, that is amplitude variation done at the transmission side. So, we are doing the reverse process here. So, here this point corresponds to fc plus del f. So, when fc plus del f will be transmitted at the transmitter side during the positive peak of the message signal. If the incoming signal is fc plus del f, then this should be converted into a positive peak amplitude. So, here at this point a positive peak is generated, and at this point fc minus del f. Here the amplitude should be negative peak. So, within this range, so from fc to fc minus del f to fc plus del f, the amplitude should vary like this. So, we are converting the variation in frequency into variation in amplitude. So, this can be done easily by this slope detector. So, this is the characteristics of the slope detector. So, this circuit is very simple, and this is the principle of slope detector, that is tuned circuit which receives the FM input signal, and the center frequency of the tuned circuit fc is detuned by a small amount of del f, that is fc plus del f and fc minus del f. A small variation in the frequency of the input will produce changes in the output. This is the way a principal FM is converted into AM. When the carrier deviation shifts the carrier in the up frequency, the signal moves up in the response curve. When the carrier deviation shifts the carrier down in the frequency, then the signal moves down the response curve, causing the reduced output voltage. This part of the slope detector gives a frequency to amplitude conversion. The advantage of this slope detector is simple and inexpensive, but the disadvantages are it is inefficient and it is linear over only limited frequency range, and it does not eliminate the amplitude variation, and output is sensitive to any amplitude variation in the input signal. That is, if we take that frequency modulated signal, only the frequency should vary, the amplitude of the modulated signal should remain constant. While transmission, the signal will be transmitted in the free space, there may be possibility for the signal to get slightly altered. The amplitude may slightly vary. So, in case of FM, the amplitude remains constant due to the noise or certain interferences. If the amplitude of the frequency modulated signal is slightly varied, then it should be removed by the limiter. So, this slope detector cannot remove that amplitude variation in the frequency modulated wave. The next we go for a balanced slope detector. This is the simple circuit that shows the balanced slope detector. It consists of two sections. Here this is the transformer, a center tap transformer. Here we have the primary and here we have the secondary, and here we have two tuned circuits. One is tuned to fc plus del f and another one is tuned to fc minus del f. Here let us consider that this is the transformer output, that is secondary of the transformer t 1 and this is t 2 or t dash and t double dash. The upper part of this circuit is tuned to fc plus del f and the lower part of the circuit is tuned to fc minus del f, and here we have two diodes and this is the output section. See that output here, here it is plus minus and here it is minus and plus. So, this is in accordance with the dot rule of the transformer, and here we are providing the frequency modulated wave to the primary of the transformer, and at the output here we will have the output gets split into two. A part of the output will be in the secondary coil here and the remaining will be available in the secondary here. Now, we will see how the input signal, frequency modulated signal, is converted into amplitude variation signal. The principle is same as that of the slope detector. Here we have two sections. When the input signal contains FC plus DLF, then you will have the maximum output at the top section. That is, when the incoming signal has a frequency of FC plus DLF, then you will have the output maximum at this section. And here there would not be any output because this section is tuned to FC minus DLF. So, we will get the maximum output, positive output. Suppose if the incoming signal have the frequency of FC. Now, since this circuit or this section is tuned to FC plus DLF and this is tuned to FC minus DLF, from the response curve of a tuned circuit, here this will generate a positive output and this section will generate a negative output, but both will be of same magnitude. And if you find the output here, let us take V 1 and minus V 1. So, what is the output? So, output will be the difference of this. So, V 1 minus V 1, it becomes 0 when in case of when the input is FC. When the input is of FC plus DLF, we will get only output in this section, that is only we will get V 1. So, here it will be 0. So, we will get positive output. And during this, when the input signal is FC minus DLF, you will get an output here, you will get the output here, and here the output will be 0. So, what will be the output? The net output? The net output will be negative. So, this can be clearly understood from the response curve. So, this is the characteristics of balanced slope detector. Here, this is FC and this is FC minus DLF and this is FC plus DLF, and this is the characteristic of that top section tuned circuit, and this is the characteristic of the bottom section, that is T double dash and T dash. So, when the input is FC plus DLF, so we will get the positive output in the top section, and here you will get the output in the bottom section. So, the net output will be positive. If you see that range here, we consider the ranges from minus 15 to plus 15. So, the output will be from plus 10 to plus 15, and here the output will be ranges from minus 5 to minus 10. If you simply sum up these two values, you will get a positive values. Now, let us see the output during FC minus DLF. So, in the top section, we will have positive output, and here see that in the negative section, see the range, here it is plus 5 to plus 10 and here it is minus 10 to minus 15, and the net output will be negative. So, this is the combined transfer curve for the balanced slope detector. Here FC minus DLF the lower end, and here FC plus DLF the upper end, and here the center frequency. See the slope of the curve. As the frequency increases, as we are moving from FC minus DLF to FC plus DLF, see the output. Here we have the negative output, and as the frequency increases and as it moves to FC, the output goes to 0, and from thereafter, when the input signal frequency is greater than FC, the output is positive, and it goes till the maximum value at FC plus DLF. So, usually we will consider this range as a useful range. This is a useful range. Balanced slope detector. The circuit uses two slope detectors connected in back to back fashion to opposite ends of the center tap transformer, hence fed with 180 degree out of phase. The top secondary circuit is tuned to above the IF frequency by an amount of DLF, and the bottom circuit is tuned below IF by an amount of DLF. Each circuit is connected to diode detectors with suitable RC loads. The output is taken across the series combination of loads, so that the sum of the individual outputs. that is when the input frequency is FC, the output of the top section, that in the secondary T dash and the T double dash will be same, but since they are 180 out of phase, the net output will be 0. And when the input frequency is FC plus del F, the output of T dash is positive and it will be greater than the output of T double dash and it is negative. So, the net output will be positive. When the input frequency is less than FC minus del F, then the output will be negative. So, the advantages: it is more efficient and more linearity than the simple slope detector. Even more, it is difficult to tune as there are 3 different frequencies to be tuned and the amplitude limiting is not provided here. Linearity: although better than single slope detector, it is not good enough. Let us have a short break. Welcome back after the break. Now, we will see faster relay discriminator. It is also called as phase discriminator. In this phase discriminator, all the tuned circuits are tuned to same frequency and it is almost same as that of balanced slope detector with some changes. This circuit provides good linearity, that is better linearity than the slope detector. Here we have only one tuned circuit, that is all the section. Here we have the primary, here we have the primary and here we have the secondary, and it is tuned to only one frequency. But whereas in the previous case, the secondaries are tuned to 2 different frequencies. And here the capacitor C, this capacitor C and the C4 are used for coupling, and bypass capacitors, these 2 act as a bypass capacitors, and the voltage across the diode will be equal to the V in plus secondary voltage by 2. Now, we will analyze the phase discriminator. If we take this phase discriminator, let us consider this inductor L2. Here it contains a small value of resistance, and now there will be mutual inductance between the primary and secondary. Using the mutual inductance concept, we are going to analyze the phase discriminator circuit. If we consider the primary, this is L2, and this inductor will contain a small resistance. So, this can be represented by R2. So, I have redrawn the transformer circuit, and here this is considered as a source. This voltage, which is nothing but a mutually induced voltage due to the current flow in the primary. So, I am redrawing the circuit. Since we are taking the output across the capacitor, we are taking the output across the capacitor. This terminal is VAB in the given circuit. Now, we will analyze this equivalent circuit to find out the output. So, this is VS, the mutually induced voltage. So, this can be given as minus M by L1 into VN. So, this is from the transformer theory. If this voltage is applied to this circuit, now what happened to the output voltage across this element, that is capacitance? So, VAB. Applying the potential division rule, the total voltage applied is VS, and now we want to find out the voltage across the capacitance. The capacitive reactance is minus J XC2 divided by R2 plus J XL2 minus J XC2. So, if you consider this is R2 and this is L2. So, this is the VAB. So, what is VS? VS is nothing but minus M by L1 into VN. VN is the applied voltage at the primary of the transformer. So, the output will be VAB equal to V in. So, I am taking this minus into minus, it becomes plus. So, M by L1 into J XC2 divided by R2 plus J XL2 minus XE2. I am combining these two parameters. So, this is the resultant expression. VAB is JM by L1 VIN XE2 by R2 plus X2. So, X2 is nothing but XL2 minus XE2. So, from this equation, we are going to see the output of the phase discriminator. So, this is the output expression. If you see this, when the input signal is purely FC, now that is XL2 minus XC2 becomes 0, because at resonant frequency or the center frequency, these two will be same. So, this becomes 0. So, here we will get R2 only. If you see this expression here, here we have R2 plus JX2. So, at center frequency FC or at carry frequency FC, these two values will be equal. So, this becomes 0. So, this is the resultant expression. VAB is nothing but JM by L1 VIN into XE2 by R2. If you see that, it is a complex number of purely imaginary, it contains only J. If we have a complex number A plus JB, so this can be, if it is purely real, it is A, and if it is purely imaginary, it is JB. In this case, the magnitude, this number can be represented in polar form. The magnitude is A and the phase angle is 0. Here, the magnitude is B and the phase angle is 90 degree. And if it is minus JB, then the magnitude is B and the phase angle is minus 90 degree. That is, in the phasor form, here we have A, here we have plus J and here we have minus J. So, what about the angle here? 0 degree, and here the angle is 90 degree and here the angle is minus 90 degree. Actually, it is 270 degree. So, we can, for our convenience, we can consider it as minus 90 degree. So, here this VAB leads the VIN by 90 degree. That is, since this is purely imaginary, this VAB leads this voltage, that is input voltage, by 90 degree. So, this is the phasor diagram for this case. Here, the output, if you take that VA naught and VB naught, this length will be same. The length of this line is same. It says that the voltage between the terminals A and O will be equal to the voltage between B and O, and see that amplitude, they are equal in amplitude, but they are opposite in phase. So, the discriminator output will be 0. When the input frequency is greater than FC, in the impedance X2, here it is nothing but XL2 minus XE2. If the input frequency is greater than FC, then XL2 will be greater than XC2. So, this parameter, this will be positive, this will be positive. Since XL2 is greater than XC2, this will be positive. And here, as I said, this J can be represented by 90 degree in polar form. And here, this complex number, the angle of this complex number is theta and the magnitude is Z2. And now, if you find the phase angle of this entire expression, it is 90 minus theta. So, the VAB leads the VIN by an angle of 90 minus theta. So, this is expressed in, as shown in the phasor diagram. If you see this VA naught and this is VB naught, see that amplitude, this is more when compared to this one. That is, VAO is greater than VBO. Here, we have to consider the length of the line. So, hence the output of the discriminator will be positive. Since this VAO is greater than VBO, the output is positive. And if we consider the next case, when the input signal frequency is less than FC, then XL2 will be less than XE2. That is, X2 is negative, or we can say that the reactance is purely capacitive. And now, if we represent this expression or the voltage VAB in polar form, so this J becomes 90 degree in polar form, and then the angle of this complex number in polar form is minus theta, and the magnitude is Z2. So, usually Z2 is nothing but root of R2 square plus X2 square, and theta is nothing but tan inverse of B by A. Here B is nothing but minus X2 by R2. So, in this case the VAB leads the V in by an amount of 90 plus theta, and here VAO and this is VBO. If you see this amplitude of VAO or the length of this line is shorter, or the amplitude is less when compared to VBO. So, the output of the discriminator will be negative. So, this is the characteristic of the phase discriminator. This is same as that of the balanced slope detector, that is here FC minus del F, and here this is FC plus del F, and these are the useful range. This figure shows the characteristic of the phase discriminator. Here in x axis it is the frequency, and in y axis the amplitude. This is the response of the phase discriminator. So, at this point the frequency will be FC minus del F, and here it will be FC plus del F. As we have seen, when the input is exactly FC, the output voltage will be 0, and when the input is FC minus del F, then the output will be negative, and when the input is FC plus del F, then the output is positive. And here we consider this range as the useful range, and beyond this the output falls due to the frequency response of the transformer. In a phase discriminator, it is much easier to align, as there are now two tuned circuits and both are tuned to same frequency, and the linearity is quite better, and the only drawback here is there is no provision for amplitude limiting. And in the today's section we have discussed about the slope detector, balanced slope detector and faster CLA discriminator. If you see that frequency modulation detection, that is we have to reconvert the frequency variation into amplitude variation. So, this process is the reverse process of frequency modulation, or we can simply call it as a frequency demodulation. And if we consider that frequency detection types, we have 4 types, and in today's section we have discussed only 3 types, and in the next section we will discuss about the next type, that is residue detector. Let us have a simple questions what we have discussed in the today's class. Explain FM detection using phase discriminator or faster CLA detector. Thank you.